can share your screen.
Yeah, sure. Are you guys able to see the screen?
Yeah.
Okay, can I start?
Yeah, please start.
Oh, thank you. Okay, guys. In last class, we discussed about frame switching, okay? Frame switching and then window switching. Today, we will discuss about Anil already discussed about weight mechanisms. And simple clicks and all already we covered it. Okay, clicks and send keys and get text, those basic operations. Today we will see drop down box. And then we discuss about page object model after that. While implementing page object model, we'll try to cover some inheritance related concepts like how to use superclass methods in subclass, okay, inheritance related concepts, and then some weight mechanisms, okay. So today we'll cover these three, and then next class we'll discuss how to read data from XMLs and how to use testng and all. Next two classes we'll discuss it. In that only I will try to cover interfaces also, okay. See, here already I have one application, okay, one web page, already designed web page is there in my system. Let me show that. This is the web page, okay, inside this prompt we have a drop down field. Okay, a drop down field. This is the drop down. It has four options: data structure, data mining, algorithms, Selenium, like that. So many options are there. How to select this? How to select this? We'll discuss it. Okay, and then we'll move to page object model. Okay, if it is a drop down box, okay, first of all, we need to find what is the element. Okay. What is the element? This drop down box element. Okay, that element we should find. Okay, and then we should pass that element as an argument to select the class constructor. There is a class select, there is a class select class. Okay, there is a class select. Okay, for this select class, we need to create object. Okay, how to create object for select class? Select s equal to new select. Okay. For this select class object, you need to pass. Okay. For this select class, while creating object, okay, we will use constructor, right? For this constructor, we need to pass object of drop down. Okay. Now, that means drop down element object. Okay, how do we get that? Driver dot find element will give web element object, right? That we need to pass. Once if you pass it, okay, in that drop down, okay, s dot whatever you want to make it visible here, like Selenium or data structure, what value you want to set it for that drop down. Okay, that we need to set it by, there are some methods, select by visual text, like that few methods are there. Using that we can set that value, select by visible text, there is a method. Okay, whatever the value you want to set, you can set it. Okay, that we will see, like data structures. Like this, we can select values for drop down. What we have to do is first we should create an object for select class. While creating object, okay, while creating object, we should pass the web element of that drop down as an argument to the constructor. And then once the drop select class object, whatever you have created, using that you can select the value whatever you want to display in that drop down. Okay, now see, this is the file, guys. First two lines, any doubt? Your line number 10 and 11, just I'm creating Chrome driver object, and then I'm trying to launch okay some URL using get. Okay, that is not from some other website, online website. It is from my TP. That's why this is the path. Okay, that path we are entering here. Okay, see here, we are entering that path of the form. Okay, now once if you do get operation, it will launch this page. After that, we should find out the object. The web element which is actually responsible for this drop down. Okay, just right click on drop down and then click on inspect. See here, this is the object, web element. Okay, so we should write XPath to find this web element. Okay, XPath, tell me guys how to find the XPath of this. Select element whose name is drop down. Okay, let me check it whether it will give the same one or not. Select element, okay, at the rate name equal to in single quotes drop down. Okay, one select element it is returning. Okay, using that XPath we can find this select element. So this select element we have to find using find method, find element method. Okay, once if you call find element method, it will return the web element of this select that we need to pass as an argument to select class constructor. Okay, now I did it. Okay, see here, driver dot find element. Okay, driver dot find element by XPath drop down. Okay, I'm trying to find that select element. Okay, that is drop down element. Okay, so here I am giving some sleep mechanism, because if you don't give sleep, what happens? Immediately it will very fast, it will select attribute first option and then select option. See here, my intention is I want to select data structures. After that, I want to show you again selecting data mining, again selecting algorithm, like that, selecting one by one. If it is doing very fast, we cannot observe that is it selecting or not. Okay, that's why I gave some time gap so that we can clearly observe whether it's selecting or not. Okay, so first of all, we need to find that drop down web element. After that, select class element I am, sorry, select class object I am creating. While creating object, we should pass that, okay, drop down box element, okay, drop down box element, whatever you found, okay, that you need to pass as an argument to select a class. After that, this select class object dot, okay, there are three ways to select the elements based on select by index. See here. Here, this whatever we are seeing here values, these are visible texts. What we call visible text. One is visible text. Select by visible text. We can do that. Whatever you want to display, either data mining, algorithms, or Selenium, whatever you want to select, that you can pass as an argument, okay, to select by visible text. Whatever drop-down options are showing, those are called select visible text. Okay, that you can pass. Another way is by select by index. S dot, okay, select by index. Select by index, okay, select by index. How many elements are there here? Four elements. Data structures, data mining, algorithms, and Selenium. Each element is having one index. First one is having zero index. Second one will be at first index. Okay. So after that, second element, second, okay, like this. First one at the zero, sorry. First one is at zero. Always index starts from zero. Second element at one. Third element at two. Fourth element at three. Okay. Based on index also we can select, okay? That is what we are doing here. Drop down, select by index, and which index you want to select, okay? Now, see here, what I am doing is selecting first index, second index, like that, I am selecting two elements. What is the first index? See here, first index, data mining, algorithms, okay? Now we'll see, we'll run and see, will it show that or not, okay? After that, after seeing those two, again, there is another way. Select by value, that we will discuss it soon. Another one, select by visible text. As I said some time back, okay, whatever the values we are seeing in drop-down, okay, based on that values also we can select. Let me show that these are the values, either Selenium, data structure, data mining, directly you can set it, okay? For that, this is the method, select by visible text, okay? Another way is, when you open source code, we can observe something. See here, inside select only, all these are options. Inside select tag only, all these are options, okay? See, for some of all options, this is the visible text. This is the visible text. In between start tag and end tag, whatever is available, that is the visible text. That only we can see on GUI. Okay? This is algorithm Selenium. Okay? There is something called value. Value attribute also available for options. Okay? If you give this value data, automatically it will select data structures. Based on this value also you can select. If you give value SEL Selenium, okay, its value Selenium, okay, it will show that visible text as Selenium. Okay, got it guys? Based on value you can select, or based on visible text you can select, or based on index also you can select. That is what I'm trying to do here. See guys, first I am launching it. Okay, after launching, I am finding the web element which is responsible for drop down. Okay, and waiting for some time, and immediately I am trying to select by index. Based on index, first two elements I am selecting. After that, every selection to observe that whether it's selecting or not, I am giving explicitly some sleep time, some time to wait. Okay, this is threaded art sleep. There is a class thread. It has a method sleep. That method sleep is a static method. So we are using, or sorry, we are calling that method using class name. Okay, how many, the parameter whatever you are passing is milliseconds. 3000 milliseconds means just 3 seconds. Okay, based on index we are selecting, and then we are covering here select by value, based on value SEL. If you give, say SEL, if you give, see here it should show Selenium. Okay, and data structures based on direct visible text. Okay, any doubt guys in this? Let me run it once. This is how we'll select values to drop down. See, data structure to data mining, and then algorithm. After that, it changed to Selenium, okay? And then data structures, okay? So based on index, based on visible text, based on value attribute, okay? We are able to select drop-down values. Any doubt in this, guys?
Venkat, I have a question. So in that program, you said like e.print stack trace, right? So what does it mean actually?
Is this one? Okay,
yeah.
One second. Yeah, I will explain that.
Okay.
See here, this full thing, whatever here, try catch. This is not related to this drop down. This is different one. Okay, now what here, this full thing. Threaded art sleep we are writing, right? Let me write it. One second. Threaded art sleep. Threaded art sleep. Okay. Threaded art sleep. Sometime we are giving. Okay. This threaded art sleep method. Okay. Will throw an exception. That is why they are, whenever you are using sleep method, automatically you will get error like this. It will throw an exception. Please handle it. Okay. So I am telling you, use a try catch. Like that I made it. Okay. This statement will throw the exception. Okay. But to handle it, I wrote try catch. Okay. E dot here, this is exception object, right? E is exception object, right?
Yes, yes.
Just it's related information. If you want to know, just it's a print statement. It is like a print statement. But when we are executing a program, this method is called by some other method, that method is called by some other method, like that. Full flow will be there, right? A method called by B, B is called by C, like that. That full stack trace, if you want to know, you should use this print stack trace. Got it?
Okay. So whatever the relating methods for that particular method will be okay.
Yeah, that flow of methods is called that, that call that, that call that, that info it will print. Okay, I will show you once. Whenever we see get exception, there will be so many lines of info. Did you guys
observe?
Yes. Yeah, that is full, that we are printing track trace. Okay? If you print also, same, that only we'll get. If you want simple help, okay, plain text, here you can see what this method will do. It will print the, it's throwable and it's back trace to the standard error stream. Okay?
Okay.
Just
thank print you.
Print at the flow.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay, thanks.
Guys, if no other doubts in this, we'll move to phase object model. Sausanya, Savitri, is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, Venkat.
Okay, guys. Let me show. This is the Gmail program. I think you guys already tried it. This only I'm going to convert it as page object model programming. Now, my intention is now I want to test Gmail. Consider I want to test Gmail now. One test case is simple test case. Login with valid credential is one test case. Now I am going to automate that. Okay, here what is the first step? Launching browser and then launching Gmail. Okay, after that there you can see an option Gmail. Okay, guys, who comfortable with finding XPath? Because here I already identified the XPath and I using it instead of identifying it here, because XPath already from past 2-3 classes you guys are trying. Okay, so I thought okay, I can it will take some time to identify, right? So that I can save that time, 10-15 minutes time. That's why I already identified this XPath. Okay, and I'm using it. First thing is, once if you launch Google page, there top side right corner we can see Gmail. It is trying to click on that. Okay, what I am doing? Driver dot find element by XPath, based on XPath, find the element whose XPath is this. Okay, this is the XPath of Gmail element. Okay, once if it finds that element, it will return it. On that element, I am performing click operation. Okay, clicking on Gmail. After that, we will get login page. In that login page, there will be a text field or input field to enter email ID. Okay, so that email ID XPath I gave, I'm identifying that, and then I'm entering data into that. That means mail ID. Okay, to enter data, we will use a method send keys. Okay, using that, I am trying to pass email ID to mail ID box. After that, click on next. Okay, identifying the next element and then clicking. After that, identifying password field XPath. Okay, and then based on that, finding the element and then entering password inside that. After that, clicking next and then clicking okay, after that, click on sign in. Once if you sign in, you can see compose option. I'm trying to click on compose. Okay, after click on compose, you will get a new mail message, small window. In that, two address will be there. Okay, I'm finding the XPath of two and then entering some mail ID to send the mail to this guy. Okay, this is to whom I supposed to send. After that, subject XPath I identified. In that, I am entering test mail as the subject and then clicking on send button. What it will do is it will click so that it will send the mail. Okay, this is how we'll send a mail. Any doubt in this, guys? Guys, any doubt in this?
No, Michael, no.
No.
Yeah. This is the simple program how to send mail. Now, one test case means we can write all these methods, identifying XPath and click and all. Okay, one test case you consider you have 1,000 options to click and all, or else one test case full flow covers 30-50 operations like clicks, entering data, XYZ operations. Okay, yeah, see guys. Sometime back you are asking Gopi, right, what is E dot print struct trace will do? This is how. There is a method main, okay, here. In our Gmail program dot main. This is the Gmail program dot main, okay. This is the Gmail program dot main. Here exception came. That's why we got this red one and exception. What is that exception? Element not visible exception. That I will explain you soon. okay, element not visible exception, okay, this exception came from which line and who is throwing that and all will track trace. Gmail program dot java line number 31. This line is okay called. When it calls this one, internally this find element is unable to find the element whatever you mentioned here. With this XPath, it failed to locate the element. At that time, what happened? Internally, these methods, when you call this line, okay, when it executes this line, it internally calls this. Okay, that calls another one. This one calls this. Like that, that is the flow. Okay? That is nothing but when you print E dot, print stack trace, we will get similar kind of one. Okay? Now, here, problem is, see guys, element not visible exception. Element not visible. It is telling here, see, in this line number, okay? Line number, you can observe, here line number 31, okay? Gmail 31, okay? Here, it failed. See the GUI? But here, element is available. Here, password one, it is telling that element is not visible. But if you see GUI, whatever it launched, that program launched this GUI. Here, that element is visible, right? Then why is it failed? See here, after entering username or password, when you click on next, okay, when you click on next, let me try it once again. It will take some time to load the next page, okay? It will take some time to load the page. Meanwhile, what is happening, it is without waiting, it is keep on going, executing the statements. It entered its email ID and then it clicked on next. After that, immediately it will try to enter password into password field. But see, after click on next, it will take some time to load that page. See, it clicked. By then, okay, after click on next, immediately it is expecting password field to be visible, but it is not visible. That page is getting refreshed with the password field options with this page. Okay, that is the reason we got this error. For this, what is the solution? Guys, for this, what is the solution? Suggest me some solution. If you wait for some time.
You have the wait option.
Yes, exactly. If you wait for some time, then this problem we can avoid it, right? See, here, if you wait for some time, we can avoid that problem. After click on next, you wait for some time, okay? Thread.sleep. Thread.sleep. For now, I will use next 2 minutes. After that, I will replace with the Selenium-1. Okay, thread.sleep. This thread.sleep, whenever you use, you should use this one. Okay, try catch. After that, we'll run. Where it will fail, we'll see. Will it go or not? If you use thread.sleep, okay, if net is very fast, what happens? Unnecessarily, you are waiting 3 seconds, right? If it is very slow, net is very slow, at that time, those 3 seconds also not enough. By the time page loads, okay, it will go to the next. It will wait for 3 seconds. If page doesn't load, it will proceed, then it will fail in the next statement. So if you give more time, unnecessarily waiting, if it already loads. If you give less time, we don't know how much time it takes. Unnecessarily, again, it will fail. Okay? So, what is the solution for that? See here, now, it clicked on next. But again, it failed on something. Right? So, like this, we will be having some issues. Okay? We will be having some issues. See, what is the one test sign in. Okay, it failed to click on that, like that it is showing. Okay, see, file failed to click on sign in. Let me run it. Maybe after password, just if you click next, then it will go inside. Maybe while copy pasting, I gave sign in also. Okay, sign in related, not required here. Let me see. After entering password, is it showing sign in?
Yes, yes.
We'll run it once and we'll see. Password, after that we are clicking next. So this is the disadvantage with this sleep mechanism. Okay, if you use this one, how much time you supposed to wait, you don't know exactly. If you give less time, it's a problem. If it doesn't load, right, it will fail. If you give more time, enter time also problem. See, after entering username, clicking on next, and then entering password, after that clicking on next, there is no option like sign in, automatically proceed to next one, that's it, right? After entering password, there instead of sign in, next is there, it clicked on next and it signed in. And for sign in, it took some time, 5 seconds, 4 seconds. By that time, after click on next, okay, it signed in. Signed in, that sign taking some time. By the time it clicked on compose immediately. Okay, that is the reason compose is not loaded by that time. That's why it is showing due text compose. Clicking on compose failed. Like that, it's showing. See here. No such element. Okay, no such element. Unable to locate this element with this XPath. You used XPath and you provided this. I'm unable to locate such element. Okay, got it? So what shall we do? We should use a sleep. Okay, instead of this sleep, if you go for Selenium sleeps, okay, what is the advantage of it? In Selenium sleeps, you can specify some amount of time. This much time it has to wait. The time whatever you are giving is max time, how much time it's supposed to wait. In before that time, if it loads the element, it will proceed to next element, next operation. If it didn't load within that time, okay, it will wait. When it reaches that maximum timeout, whatever you have mentioned, at that time it will throw the exception. Okay, it will throw the exception. Got it? If it loads, no problem. It will wait till it loads and it will proceed. Okay? Unable to find that element means maximum it will wait how much time you have said. Okay? After that also it didn't find means it will throw the exception. Now, instead of writing these 5 lines every place, just let me write inside one method, simple method, okay? Because every time we need this, right? Every time we need this. That's why I am writing a method. Guys, first I will write this as it is, this thread.sleep only. Give me some time. After some time, I will replace this with Selenium sleeps, okay? Now consider, everywhere we need to use this, right? So I am writing a class whose name is a helper. Okay, there I will write this as a method. Okay, public static sleep. Second, guys, public statics sleep. Okay, this sleep you you implement here, and you take the time whatever they want to, okay, how much time they want to wait in milliseconds, that only you mention here. Instead of writing these 5 lines every time, just call this sleep, okay, so that it will be 1 line, okay. So public static sleep milliseconds. To milliseconds. Guys, please tell me what is the issue here. Change set method to return type for the method. Okay, public static void. We missed the return type. While writing a method name, okay, we should write return type also, right? That return type we missed it, that's why it showed. Now onwards, here whenever I want to use, okay, instead of writing that big line, just a helper dot sleep. I will call that method and I will pass how much time I supposed to wait. Sorry, somehow my Eclipse connection got closed. Let me open it. Helper dot sleep. Okay, and how much time it's supposed to wait? Just give 3 milliseconds, we'll see. Okay, now after click on next, also we should wait for some time because to load that Gmail it is taking some time, like give 15 seconds. Okay, and then run it, we'll see how it will goes. Guys, did you understand that sleeping mechanism, implicit and explicit, two types of sleeping mechanisms?
Yes, okay.
Yes,
okay.
Now we will replace that sleep with Selenium sleep, okay? it's over. Okay, completed. Now we'll go here and it's working fine. Now in a helper.class, this statement we should replace. Okay, and we'll replace it soon. And every time, what operations generally we will perform? Generally, what operations we perform? Click, send keys. Okay, most commonly used operations are these. For those, also we'll write a method. Instead of calling this every time, okay, just pass the X path and then call it. Okay, because now we are going to write only one or two test cases. That's why it looks like if you write all these things, full statements everywhere, okay, that is also fine, less code like that we may fail. But the advantage of using this helper commonly used methods in some other class and then inheriting it and then using that brings more difference, okay, when we are automating more test cases. Let me move here. Here, find element and then click. Okay, that find element and click also, simply we will use a method click. Okay, for that click, what is the X path where you want to perform that? Only that only will pass as an argument. Okay, inside a helper class, okay, write a method click. Public static void click. Okay, whenever you want to click, what is required, where to click, that element XPath is required, right? XPath value. Okay, so you are writing a method for performing click operation. Okay, that will do the click operation. Whatever clicks are there, here, see driver.findElement, pull this one, you take it, and write inside this. Okay. Here, this XPath value, whatever they will pass, you replace it with this. Okay. Now, driver. Driver object also, we need it. Whenever somebody calls click method, they have to pass driver object also. For example, from this Gmail program, one time they are creating driver. Same driver only will use everywhere. Okay, driver. Okay, driver object, comma, and XPath of the element. You can call click method by passing two arguments. Okay, here in click method you take another argument, web driver. Okay, so web driver we should import, it is not available in the same package. Okay, now in Gmail what they will do, they will click this. Okay, they will, instead of writing this statement, what they will do, simply click. Okay, click where to click the text path. Okay, now see here, this click it is showing error. Why? Tell me guys. Simply click means, can you get it? Simply click means, will you get that click method here? How to access members of another class?
No,
by creating an object,
either object or class name. If it is a static member, use class name. If it is non-static, use class name. Or another way is, if it is having any relation to that class, okay? If it is having any relation to that class, okay, you can directly use those methods as your own methods. Through inheritance, you will get those methods, right? That is why I am frequently used methods. Everywhere commonly used methods we are keeping inside one class, okay, and we are making it as a helper class, and we will extend that class for all the classes so that commonly used methods without creating object and all directly we can use it. Now I extended helper class so that click one will get. Okay, now click. After that, this one. For this, what shall we do? Enter data. Like that, can we write a method? Guys, don't think why are we writing this. Soon, in half an hour, you will understand why is it required and all. Okay? So, we are writing another method. Public static void enter data. Okay? For entering data, what are the two things you supposed to tell? Tell me, guys. If I say enter data, what and all required? Where to enter data? That element X path, right? And what data it's supposed to enter?
Send keys.
Internally, it will use send keys. Okay, we can write send keys also, anything. Okay. Just we are giving some method names. Okay. So send keys, anything. Okay. This method we will call, internally it will call actual method send keys. Okay, this one you can give enter data or input data, send keys, anything is okay. Fine. Right. Now, here, send keys, okay, send keys, send keys. So for send keys also one is driver is required, okay, to perform, because to perform driver dot find element, driver object is required, and another one X path of the element, right, X path of the element. And input data, what data you want to enter inside that, okay? This is input data, okay? Now, go and write this method here, web driver, and X path of that, in addition to that, one more parameter, string input data, right? Now, here, replace this and keep it there. Control X. See here. Replace this with the X path value. Replace this with X path value. And other one with input data. Okay. Now send keys. Okay. And again click element only. Okay. Click element. See here. Whenever you call click, automatically it will show click. Okay. You pass that. This is the X path you want to click on it, right? This is the X path you want to click on it. After clicking on next, wait for sleep, some sleep, okay? And here helper also not required because we made that class, okay? Extend subclass, super class of this current class, right? This current class where we are writing program. This is a subclass of the helper class. So directly you can call that sleep method, okay, without class name. Now, after that, tell me guys, how to replace this statement?
Again, send keys.
Send keys, right? Send keys. Send keys. One is driver, another one is XPath. Okay. After that, input data. Okay. Now this is not required. After that, again click on next. Okay. Again click on next. So this click on next also over, and then after entering password, if it waits for some time, it will log in. Okay. Now it will wait for this. Okay. And then
again click.
Click and pass this X path. Okay. And after that, send keys. Okay. Send keys. This is the X path. This is the X path. And this is the value. This is the value. Okay. And this is not required. After that, again same, send keys. Send keys. And this is the X path. And other one is input data. Right, this is the input data. For time being, we are entering username, mail ID, all these here only. This data we will, in next class, we will learn how to parse data from XML. Once if you parse data from XML, how to you pass it and pass it, we will replace these statements at the time. Okay. Now, finally, click. Okay. Click method. After click on Gmail, did we get login page?
No.
No. Sometimes what is happening, we will get this, right? We will get this page. Here if you click on sign in, then it will go to login page. See here. Let me find the X path of it once and then we'll click on it. After click on your A tag, whose value is, sorry, whose text is sign in. Dollar X. Dollar X. Whose A tag, whose text equal to sign in. Okay, so it returns that element, so we can use that. So this time we need to click here, after click on Gmail, right? After click on Gmail, with this X path, we need to click. We need to click. This is the X path. Just click on it. But last time, two times we tried. At that time, did we get this sign in, guys? After click on Gmail option in Google page, did we get this page?
No.
No, directly we got this login page. Let it load. Directly after click on Gmail, we got this login page. But this time we got that advertisement related page. On that, there is something called sign in option. We have to click. That sometime occurs, sometime doesn't occur. Okay, now what to do? Here, this is in between, it is there, right? Here, sorry. After click on Gmail, this line, sometimes it may come, may not come. Okay, now what to do is you write it, okay? If it comes, it will click. If it doesn't come, what happens? First, let me run it now. See here, this time, why is it failed? It is telling unable to identify the element email because it did not get that login page. Still, it did not get because intermediate some other page loaded. Okay, now here, let me run it. We added that, okay? This time also, after click on Gmail, if you get that page, it will click on sign in. If you don't get that page, if you don't get that page, what happens? It will try to click on sign in and it will say, I did not find sign in element, unable to locate sign in element, and then it will throw the exception, right? It will throw the exception means program execution will be terminated, right? Then how to handle it? Okay, see here, this time we did not get it, that page, right? Where sign in is available. That's why it tried to click on sign in, but it did not find that sign in. No such element. Okay, sign in. Okay, so what? How to handle it? Sometimes we may get, sometimes we are not. That's why you write in try catch, try block you write, okay? Instead of stopping that program execution, because if it tried to click, it did not find that element, so it will throw the exception. Whenever exception occurs, what happens? Program execution will stop, right? It will stop the program execution. It will come out of that execution. To avoid that one, okay, if you handle it, if you handle that exception using catch block, okay? Catch. Catch. Now what happens, tell me? Consider that option came. At the time it will click and it will not enter into catch block, it will go to next line. Consider that option did not come. At the time it will wait for some time and it will try to click, it will throw exception element not found, but we handled it, so program execution will not terminate it and it will proceed to next line. Got it? Got it, guys? Whenever exception comes, you are handling, your program execution will go smooth. If you don't handle it, there only it will stop. Okay? That's why we are handling it here. Okay? If that exception comes, okay, no problem. It will go smooth after that also. So sometime back it executed, right? We only sent test mail to the same mail ID. That's why at 6:11, okay, 20 minutes back, we have a mail. We got one mail. Okay. Now it is trying to send another mail. Let's see. Okay, message has been sent. Just check once. Second mail also we got at 6:31 just now. Okay, now here sleeps. How to avoid these sleeps? How to avoid these sleeps? This sleep should be replaced with Selenium waiting mechanism. So you guys understood the advantage and disadvantage of implicit and explicit. When you write implicit sleep, driver dot manage dot timeout dot some sleep time if you give, what is the disadvantage? What is the disadvantage?
It will be for the entire program.
Yeah, that is one thing. Other than that, even though if it is for entire program, consider I set it to 120 seconds or else 15 minutes. 15 minutes we set it. That is 15 into 60 into 60 something, some seconds. Okay? We set 1 hour. What is the problem? Once if you set it, driver object to 1 hour waiting time, if it loads, it will proceed, right? Selenium waiting mechanism, once element loads, it won't wait till that max time how much you are sitting. It will proceed, right?
Yes.
Whether it is implicit or explicit, whatever it might be, whenever it consider implicit waiting mechanism, you have set 60 seconds. It loaded that element in 5 seconds. Then immediately it will go to next operation. It won't wait till max 60 seconds. In that scenario, if same time comes to all the elements also, what is the problem? No problem for us, right? Because unnecessarily we are not waiting. Whenever it finds, you set a maximum timeout in your programming or in our application, if you consider this is the maximum time taking element or operation, for that you consider 5 minutes, you set driver timeout as 5 minutes max, so that all operations will go smooth without failing. If it loads immediately, it will proceed. If it doesn't load, it will wait, no problem, right? There, disadvantage in implicit is, will check the DOM tree, whether element present or not, whether it is available or not, only that option only it will check. For example, my intention is I want to click on an element. Okay, I am using implicit wait. Okay, implicit wait 60 seconds. In 5 seconds, element loaded. Okay, then immediately it will think, okay, element loaded. Got it. Then go to next operation. Next operation is like click, you consider. It will try to click. Some elements, if you are using Ajax and all internally, some elements, even though element available, that clickable property, to enable that clickable property, it may take some time. Okay? In that scenario, element available, then immediately it will proceed. But our operation will fail saying that this element clickable is not in the state of clickable. You cannot perform a click on this element like that. We will get an error. Understood the issue?
Yes, yes.
So, in implicit, just you are setting the time. Just to wait till that element available or present or something, internal condition. That is internal. It is not in our control. But clickable property also, I want to wait till clickable property enables. Like that, based on some condition. Until some condition meets. Okay, till that time, if I want to wait, I should go for explicit wait. There, we can set time, max timeout, okay, how much is the max time period it's supposed to wait. And one more thing is, till some condition meets, please wait. Even though element finds, don't proceed. Please wait till its clickable property enabled. Okay? Got it, guys? Like that, some expected conditions also you can specify. Okay? Till some condition meets, it will wait. And then it will proceed so that our program will not fail. Okay? That is why now what I am going to do is, I will replace that sleep. Okay? I will remove the sleep. See here? For all the elements, we cannot write sleep like this. Even if you write also, this is a disadvantage. Unnecessarily, we have to wait. Even though element loads. If it doesn't load, then immediately it will fail. Right? Got it? So you cannot give too much time because unnecessarily waiting. You cannot give less time also. So that we should use Selenium sleeps. In that Selenium sleeps also, we have two types of sleeps, implicit and explicit. In implicit, disadvantage is it will wait only for that element presence. It will not check for any conditions. If you want to specify some condition also, you should use explicit sleep. Okay? Got it? Now, here in a helper file, see guys, here in our test case, I removed those sleeps. Definitely it will fail, right? Because sleeps are not there. That's why what I am going to do is, in a helper class, wherever I am performing the operations, either click or entering data, whatever it might be, what I will do is, I will wait for some condition using explicit Selenium explicit wait. Okay, I will wait till that element is clickable property enabled. Please wait. Like that I will specify so that till it loads, it will wait. Then only it will perform this operation. Got it? Here we need to write logic, right, to wait until some expected condition occurs. Okay, then only perform below operation of entering the data. Similarly, in click also. Okay, for now, so is this required? Once if you are going to implement that, is this sleep mechanism required? No, it's not required. Okay. So here also, externally sleep like that, no need to write while implementing program, test case, right? Because here I removed the sleeps also, because in that click method only we are handling that, okay? Here how to write that logic. Tell me guys, how to write explicit wait? How to write explicit wait? Please tell me. Which class object we have to create? There is a class web driver wait. There is a class web driver wait. That web driver wait will take two parameters. That web driver wait will take two parameters. One is driver object, another one is how much time it has to wait, max time. Okay, using that web driver wait object, inside that there is a method until. Okay, there is a method until. Okay, you should call that method until. First we have to create web driver wait class object. There is a class web driver wait. See, web driver wait, one class is there. Okay. Web driver wait w equal to new web driver wait. First we have to create object of this class. Inside that there is a method until. Okay, what it will do is it will wait until that. Okay, but while creating WebDriver wait object, okay, see here, if you see WebDriver wait, sorry, it will take time and WebDriver object. Okay, see here, driver and match time, shall we give 1 minute, that is 60 seconds? Give 60 seconds. Okay. Now, using that W, okay, using that W, until there is a method until, inside that until, okay, expected conditions, there is a class expected conditions, okay, that has a method until element clickable, okay, element to be clickable, element to be visible, like that some properties related methods are there. Here for us clickable means okay, fine, all the things will be enabled, like that we'll consider and we'll use that, okay, until, sorry, expected conditions, there is a class expected conditions, expected conditions, okay, it has a method element to be clickable, it has a method element to be clickable, okay, element to be clickable, element to be clickable, okay, element to be clickable, which element? Here you have to specify by that element how to find the way, okay, you should tell by XPath, okay, based on XPath you use that XPath value, you pass here, okay, whatever the element you are calling to click, okay, using your Gmail program you are telling click and some XPath you are passing, okay. Till that element gets clickable property enabled, it will wait, okay? And at the end, what it will do, this until method, it will wait until that, and it will return that web element, okay? And it will return that web element, okay? So let me assign to web element. One second, guys. Okay, until that element gets clickable property, this until method will wait until that. Okay, after that, once if it finds, it will return that element, web element, okay, WER element to be clicked. Element to be clicked, okay, which element you want to click, okay, see here, web element, this class is not available inside this package, that's why it is showing error, we should import that class, web element, okay, 1 second. Import web element. Similarly, okay, same logic we should write in below also, okay, so after that element to be clicked, that element we will get, element to be clicked, just perform click operation, you got the element right, just click it. Earlier what are we doing, we are only finding that element and all here in this logic, right, see in line number 21, we are only finding that element and then we are clicking. Instead of that one, what are we doing? We are calling that until method. It will find and return, and in addition to that, it will wait till it meets some condition, whatever we are expecting. Okay? Now, same one copy paste below also. Okay? Got it? Directly, sorry, here. See here, XPath value we are passing, and it will wait until that. Sorry, here we should create this also. Okay. And element to enter data. Where to enter data, that element it will return. Okay. On that, we have to call send keys method. Okay. Instead of click, what it should be? Send keys. Okay. For that, input data, whatever user pass, that data we need to pass. Guys, any doubt in this? No doubt, right?
Yeah.
See,
no, no.
Yeah. Tell me, Gopi.
No doubt.
Okay. See, from now onwards, how many classes you will write? How many test cases you will implement? Everywhere, no need to write this waiting mechanism logic. Simply call this method, click or send case. Okay. It will only take care of that waiting, okay, till that element loads and its properties enabled and all. Okay. Now, that time whatever we are setting is the max time. That time whatever we are setting is the max time. Now, in that time, if element loads or finds with that expected condition, it will go smooth. Otherwise, it will throw an exception. Okay? If it is unable to find that within that time, it will throw an exception. Okay? So it sent the mail, just check it once. 48, right? 11, 31 and 48. Checking the time. Okay, just now we got mail. Okay. Now, one more thing is, in any application, how many pages we can expect? See, in Gmail, or else you take, this is simple our one. In Gmail also, we will explain soon. First one, whenever you launch, this is the first page. Not this. One second, let me go back. Guys, 1 minute. Guys, give me 2 minutes. I will be back in 2 minutes.